You could say he wrote the book on robbing pharmacies. James Fogle's novel, Drugstore Cowboy, was about the life he lived to feed his drug addiction. Matt Dillon made his story a cult classic back in 1989.
Hey! Hit the local points of interest.
Decades later, it seems Fogle hasn't kicked the habit.
When we, you know, were able to identify him positively and see that he was 73-year-old, yeah, that's a bit older than what we're used to seeing.
Police say Fogle and his partner Shannon Benn burst into this pharmacy in Redmond last night wearing hoods and bandanas and flashing guns.
They began tying down two of the three employees there, told the third one to go and turn off the lights at the front of the store.
And that, as it turns out, was finally Fogle's undoing. The employee managed to tell a person walking by to call 911. Soon several squad cars and officers surrounded the store. Police say Fogle and his partner tried to escape out the back door, but officers were here waiting for them. We're told they were carrying two trash bins full of drugs. Pharmacists inside told me those are narcotics, and now that they're evidence, they're having to send some of their customers to other drugstores around the area to fill out their prescriptions. Over the years, James Fogle hasn't just shown creativity in his writing. Even some of his targets were impressed by his ideas, like this drugstore owner in Centralia.
Quite frankly, you do have to appreciate his technique.
Police say Fogle and another man actually sawed through the wall of a grocery store to get into that pharmacy.
A pretty slick deal. I think they were a lot better carpenters than they were finding the drugs, because we actually had them locked in a safe.
Fogle got away in that one. No such luck in Redmond last night. He might have found the drugs, but he's also found a jail cell again, and so the book on his criminal life still isn't closed. In Redmond, John Hopperstead, Q13, Fox News.